Greetings and welcome. Today we will see the topic homogeneous system of equation. In previous lecture we have learned that if this matrix B is a zero matrix or null matrix, we can say the system is homogeneous. And for the homogeneous system, say if you have m be the number of equations and n be the number of unknown in the system, then there are again two cases. First case is m not equal to n and m equal to n greater than 3. For this case, we'll check, find the rank. If you observe that rank of this matrix is equal to number of unknown in the system, system possesses a unique solution. That unique solution is nothing but trivial solution. Trivial solution, that means all the unknowns x1, x2, xn will be equal to 0. Second condition will be if you have rank of A less than n, number of unknown in the system, system has infinite number of solution. But if you have 3 equations, 3 unknown, then in this case we first find determinant value. If determinant is not equal to 0, we know that A inverse exists, and if A inverse exists, that is unique. Therefore, the system possesses unique solution, and that unique solution is nothing but trivial solution. That means all the unknowns will be equal to 0. And if you observe that determinant of A equal to 0, then system possesses infinite number of solution. That solution is known as non-trivial solution. We'll take one example on this. Say 4x minus y plus 2z plus t equal to 0. Second one, 2x plus 3y minus z minus 2t equal to 0. 7y minus 4z minus 5t equal to 0. 2x minus 11y plus 7z plus 8t equal to 0. Suppose if you want to solve this system of equation, what you have? How many equation? 1, 2, 3, 4. And how many unknown? X, Y, Z and T. So there are 4 equations and 4 unknown. So for this we will go for this procedure. That is M equal to N greater than 3. So you have to first write down this system in matrix form. We'll write down this system in matrix form as 4 minus 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, 0, 7. Minus 4, minus 5, 2, minus 11, 7, 8 into the matrix of unknown, that is x, y, z and t equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. So you have to solve this homogeneous system. So if I'll perform the operation, we can say like this. Now it is easy to bring 0 with the help of these 2 as well as in this 2 position, because 2 is multiple of 2 as well as 4 is also multiple of 2. Later on we'll interchange the rows. Say perform the operation r1 minus 2r2. This is already 0, or you can say r4 minus R2. If I'll perform this 2 operation, so we are performing operation with the help of R2. So there will be no change in R2. R2 will be as it is, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2. I will consider augmented matrix. So this is 0. This is already 0. We are not performing any operation on third row. So this third row will be as it is. We are performing R4 minus R2. 2 minus 2, 0. Minus 11, minus 3, that is minus 14, 8 and 10. Now if I'll perform R1 minus 2R2, you'll get 0, minus 7, 4 and 5. Now if I'll interchange R1 with R2, say R1 interchange with R2, we will get 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, 0, minus 7, 4, 5, remaining two rows will be as it is 7 minus 14 minus 4 8 minus 5 10. This second and third row, sorry, third and fourth row will be as it is. Now if with the help of this minus 7 will try to bring 0 in its lower position by using the operation say R3 plus R2 and R4 minus 2R2. If I'll perform these two operations, you'll get 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, 0, minus 7, 4, 5. These two elements will be 0. Now there is no further row operation, so this is your last echelon form. In this we'll get rank of A equal to rank of AZ, 0 matrix, equal to 2. Rank of A equal to rank of AZ equal to 2 less than number of unknown in the system. 4 is what? Number of unknown. We have the unknown X, Y, Z and T. So there will be 4 minus 2, that is equal to 2 arbitrary parameters that you have to assume. In a solution, there will be 2 arbitrary parameters. If I write down the equation, you have 2x plus 3y minus z minus 2t equal to 0. Next equation is minus 7y plus 4z plus 5t equal to 0. Now you have to assume 2 parameters. If I say t is equal to a and z is equal to b, you'll get value of y, that y is equal to, if I substitute this value here, it is 4b plus 5a upon 7. Substitute this value of y, z and t in the above equation, you'll get the answer for x, that x is equal to minus a minus 5b upon 14. So this is value of x and these are the values for x, y, z and t. Like this we'll solve the homogeneous system. Procedure remains same as that is in non-homogeneous system. There is no change in the procedure. You have to reduce to the echelon form and then you have to find its solution. We'll take one more equation. Say x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 0. 2x plus 3y plus z equal to 0. 4x plus 5y plus 4z equal to 0. X plus y minus 2z equal to 0. Again we have system of what? M is equal to 4. 4 equation. Number of unknowns are 3. Now if I'll consider the augmented matrix A, Z, you'll get 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 4, 5, 4, 1, 1, minus 2. Since this is 0, there will be no change when we perform the operations. So now with the help of this one, we'll try to bring 0 in its lower position. What is the operation? R2 minus 2R1. R3 minus 4R1, R4 minus R1. If I'll perform this operation, we have written this operation so that these three elements will be 0. There is no change in the first row. These three elements must be equal to 0. This is 0, so there will be no change. Only have to perform operations for this. You'll get minus 1, minus 5. Minus 3, minus 8, minus 1, minus 5. Again, with the help of this minus 1, you have to bring 0 in its lower position. If I'll perform the operation, say R3 minus 3R2. Next one is R4 minus R2. You'll get first row as it is 1, 2, 3, 0. Second row, we are performing operation with the help of second row, so there is no change in this. These are already 0. We have written the operation so that these two elements should be 0. So this is 0, this is 0. Only have to perform operations for this. This is 0. And you'll get here 7. So what we observe, what is rank of A? Now in this case, rank of A equal to rank of AZ equal to, see the number of arbitrary constant. In this there are three arbitrary rows. So the rank of the matrix is 3, which is equal to number of unknown in the system. Number of unknown in the system. Therefore the system possesses unique solution. And that unique solution is nothing but trivial solution. Trivial solution, that means x, y, z equal to 0. I will prove this. If I write down the equation, it is x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 0. Minus y minus 5z equal to 0. From last equation you have 7z equal to 0. This will give you z equal to 0. Substitute this value here, you will get y equal to 0. If I'll put both these values in the above equation, you'll get x equal to 0. So we have the trivial solution, x equal to 0, y equal to 0, z equal to 0. That means if you have rank of A equal to rank of AZ equal to number of unknown in the system, system possesses unique solution, and that unique solution is nothing but x, y, z equal to 0. We'll take one more example. See, if I want to find the condition on K, find condition on K so that the system has non-trivial solution, non-trivial solution, or we can say the trivial solution also. If I'll consider say x plus 2y minus z equal to 0, 3x plus k plus 7 into y minus 3z equal to 0. Say the third equation as 2x plus 4y plus k minus 3 into z equal to 0. Now what we observe, how many equations? We have 3 equations and 3 unknowns. So first we'll write down the matrix, given system in matrix form. 1, 2, minus 1, 3, k plus 7, minus 3, 2, 4, k minus 3, into the matrix of unknown, that is x, y, z equal to 0, 0, 0. Now you have 3 equations, 3 unknowns, so we first find the determinant value. Determinant of A equal to k plus 7 into k minus 3. Plus 12 minus 2 in bracket 3 into k minus 3 plus 6 minus 1 in bracket 12 minus 2 into k plus 7. If you solve this determinant, you will get determinant of A equal to k square minus 1. Now we will discuss the cases. If determinant of A not equal to 0, that means k square minus 1 not equal to 0. That means we can say k not equal to plus minus 1. System has trivial solution. System has trivial solution. And we want non-trivial solution. So for the non-trivial solution, we must have determinant of A equal to 0, that is k equal to plus minus 1. System has non-trivial solution. Like this we'll discuss. So this is the value of k for which the system of equation has a non-trivial solution. In the next lecture we'll take linear dependence and independence of vector. Thank you for watching this complete video. Have a nice day.